If you spend too much time digging through files, chasing approvals, or trying to get everything organized, this video is for you. Because today, I'm going to show you how to set up a workflow that streamlines all that chaos. No more manual sorting or endless email follow-ups. By the end of this tutorial, you'll have a simple way to handle all of your form submissions and automatically create folders in Google Drive. So, let's get started. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And here we are within one of my favorite tools, JotForm. Now, yes, Google Forms is great, but Google Forms does have its limitations. JotForm gives us so many more options, including a new option called Workflows. And here we are looking at a simple workflow so that I can have my clients submit some requested documents. And if I do choose to approve their submission, it will automatically create a folder, a subfolder within Google Drive with their name, their submission date, anything that I want. And best of all of this is customizable. So let me walk you through what this looks like and how easy it is to set up. So let's start with the form itself. And of course, I can come up here and edit the form, but let's just take a quick sneak peek at this form. It is a client onboarding form where I'm going to ask them to simply fill out their name and their email address. And I want them to send me their resume, their business plan, and their organizational chart. Now, you can customize these forms to any way that you like. In this example, the key thing here is that they are sending me actual files, and I want to be able to organize those files in Google Drive in a meaningful way. Jumping back to our workflow builder, if I click on the integrations tab, you can see that there are so many different types of applications and integrations that you can integrate with. So whether you use MailChimp or MailerLite for your email newsletters, whether you use QuickBooks for your accounting, whether you use Asana or Airtable for project management, there is definitely an integration here that will help you as a part of your workday. But in this example, we're going to use Google Drive. Next up, I have an approval step. So as soon as they submit that form, I'm going to receive an email notification. I'm also going to receive a notification here within JotForm, so I don't have to rely on my email inbox. And then I can choose to either approve it or deny it. Now, if I approve it, not only will they receive an email notification that their request or their submission has been accepted, but it is then going to send me their files in a folder with their name. It's not just going to dump it into a single folder, because you don't want to be managing hundreds, if not thousands, of submissions from the same form. No, you want to be able to go and find them and make use of those submissions. So let me show you how this works. I'm going to click on this one and I'm going to say view the form. Let's actually do this with a test client. So I'm going to pretend that I am one of my own onboarding clients. So let's come up here with a name. I'm going to say this is going to be Sally Fenderson, something like that. We're going to say that the email address is sf@example.com. And then down below, here are the three file uploads that I want. Now, in my example, I'm just going to grab a few different PDFs here. I'm going to grab this PDF here. I'm going to come down here, maybe grab this text file. Let's add that. And then this third one, let's add this text file as well. So I've got three different documents here. I have filled out all the required fields and I'm going to select submit. Now, keep in mind, you can customize these forms any way that you like. You can customize this welcome message, or you could redirect them back to your website, for example. But what is the next step here? Well, it should be coming to me for an approval. So one, I will receive an email notification letting me know that I have an approval, that there's been a new form submission. But just to remind you why I've put this in the middle of sending it to my Google Drive account, because what if this is more of a public form, right? This is something that is available to anyone on my website. I don't want anyone sending me information or uploading documents. Also, if they've incorrectly filled out this form, I don't want that sent to my Google Drive account either. So that's why I've put this approval step in the middle. Now, moving over into my JotForm inbox, here is where I will find my submissions. So I don't even have to leave my JotForm account. And here we can clearly see that just 1 minute ago, Sally Fenderson submitted this form. Here are all of the details of her submission. It includes all of the files, so I can download and review them myself. And then down at the bottom, here is that built-in approval step. So I can either choose to approve and deny it here with these buttons, but there's also a field to add in a comment. Now, if I'm going to approve it, I'm probably not going to add a comment, but remember, if I choose to deny, it's going to send this to my virtual assistant. So this would be a great place where I could give her some further instructions. I could say something like, please ask them to submit a more detailed business plan, or they forgot to submit the resume. Could you please reach back out to them? Something along those lines. If I wanted to eliminate the need of my virtual assistant, I could, of course, add other steps to my workflow so that they would receive an automatic email. But again, depending on your needs, you can customize this any way that you like. I'm going to select approve in this case. And now that it has been approved, not only will that email be sent directly to the client, letting them know that it's been approved, but of course, it's going to send it to my Google Drive account. So let's jump into my Drive account. I've created this folder, this high-level folder called JotForm Submissions. And if I click on it, here we have Sally Fenderson along with the date in which she submitted that form. Now, I could have this include any type of information from that form. Not only could I customize it, but I could say include the names of the files that she uploaded, include her email address, whatever information that you've included there. If I open up this folder, here we have those three particular files. With using this simple workflow, there was no manual process or manual steps here within Google Drive. I didn't have to add attachments. I didn't have to forward it to a Google Drive. It created the name, it created the folder, and included all of those files right here for myself or my assistant or anyone else on my team to go ahead and access. Now, coming back to the workflow builder itself, remember, you don't have to stop your workflow at this point. So for example, maybe I can come down here and I'm going to eliminate this little step here. I'm gonna hit confirm. So this time around, I'm gonna come over here to the left-hand side and you can see under the basic tab, we have all of the different steps that we can add. Here we have the approval that we've used already. Here's the email that we've used here as well, but I could add other forms, including a payment form, including a signed document if I want. So for example, if I wanted to send them another form, I can simply click and drag, move it here into my workflow. Of course, I'm going to have to select which form or create a new one if I like. I'm going to send this information request form, and I will need to include an email address. Who am I sending this form to? Well, of course, it's going to be the person who started out this entire workflow. I'm going to hit save, and then all I need to do is hover over these elements. I'm going to drag it here to this request form, and then I'm going to drag it to end. And perfect, in just a matter of seconds, I added another element to my workflow. Now you can use JotForm workflows absolutely for free. To do so, go to jotform.com or click the link in the description down below. And if you want to learn even more ways to go from overwhelmed to organized, I suggest you click on one of these videos next. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.